DATESBETWEEN is a table function that returns a set of dates in between the two boundaries that you specify in the function. It requires a date table because it returns values that need to be present in the date table you use as a reference. Let's see some examples. I define two variables, start date and end date, that contains the 15th of August 2008 and the 31st of August 2008. DATESBETWEEN requires first an argument, which is the column that it will return, in this case date, then start date and end date. And the result of this query is the set of dates in the date table that happen to be between the two boundaries, from the 15th to the 31st of August. The two boundaries are always included. So DATESBETWEEN returns both the first date, all the dates in between, and the last date. You can specify blank for one of the two arguments. If start date is blank, that means the minimum date, where by minimum we mean the minimum date that is present in the date table. So if for start date we use a blank and for end date we use the 31st of August 2008, DATESBETWEEN returns all the dates starting from the 1st of January 2005, which is the first date that is present in our calendar table. The same happens for the maximum. If you provide a blank for the maximum value, that is the largest date which is present in your calendar table. You always need to pay attention to dates present in the calendar table, because if you specify arguments to DATESBETWEEN that do not belong to the calendar table, that are either earlier or later than the first and last date in the calendar table, they will not be considered, and at maximum you obtain the dates which are present in the calendar table. In my model, I have a date starting from 2005. I can specify 2004-1-1, which is a date that is not present in my table, and the result of my query is starts from 2005. So even though I requested dates starting from 2004, I do not obtain them because there are no dates in 2004 present in my date table. Let's now take a look at a practical usage of DATESBETWEEN. In this example, we compute the moving average of the sales amount over the last 30 days. To compute that, sales last 30 days creates a variable last 30 days that takes DATESBETWEEN in the date table starting from the last day visible in the filter context minus 29. Remember, the boundaries are included, so if you want 30 days you need to subtract 29, because the bottom and the top margin will be included in the result. So all the dates between the maximum date minus 29 and the maximum date. This DATESBETWEEN returns a table containing the 30 days, which is later used by Calculate in order to compute the sales amount for these last 30 days. If you run the query, you obtain the sales amount and sales in 30 days, which is the moving average over the last 30 days. Keep in mind, this is just an example. If you need to compute moving average, DATESBETWEEN is probably not your best option. You can use dates in period, which provides a smoother syntax to compute this kind of calculations.